Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to create a user in SQL Server Express, and then using that user ID you can connect to SQL Server from Visual Studio Code. Okay, so you can see Visual Studio Code is already open here, but before we progress with this, the prerequisite that is that you need to have a user ID or a user in SQL Server Express. Okay, so for example here, like I have this SQL Server Express database. Okay, so this is a for people who don't know, so SQL Server Express is basically a development version. You can use install locally. The link is there in the description below, so you can download SQL Server Express, and then once you install it, you can use it for your development purpose. Okay, it is free, by the way. So in order to connect, so let me first disconnect these instances here. So for example, I already have this SQL Express here, and I have a user called as SA user, which uses SQL Server authentication, and I can log in using this user. I also have Windows authentication, so I using that also I can log in. You can see here that I'm able to log in. Let's close this window. Yeah, so you can log in using Windows authentication as well as SQL Server authentication. Now this I have configured when I installed SQL Express. So you can first install SQL Express, and after that you need to create a user. So follow the steps to create a user. First go to SQL 2019 configuration. Okay, so click on yes, it opens up, and here find out this network configuration, okay, and protocols for SQL Express. So here by default it will be disabled, so you need to enable it. Double click this, this window comes up, and in this drop down you can select yes, and so this will be enabled. Second, go to IP address, scroll down. Here you can see this TCP dynamic ports. So whatever value is here, just if it's zero also just make it blank, and then TCP port give anything. Like I have given 1390, you can give any number. Okay, like 1500, 1600, any number, just give that number, and then that's it from your configuration point of view. So click on OK, and once you do that, you have to restart this. Okay, so right click this and restart. So that's the process, that's the initial configuration. Once that is done, go here, and here if you have already enabled Windows authentication, log in here, and then double click or right click properties, not double click but just right click properties, and then here in security select SQL Server and Windows authentication mode. So ensure that this is selected. All right, and then once you have that, I think you don't need to do anything else. Let me just check quickly. Yes, so everything else is fine. You just need to select this one. Now click on OK. And the third step is you need to create a database. I hope that you already have a database. If not, you can create new database by right clicking on this. So you create the database, and then we have to create a database user. Okay. So go to security here, and you can see users. So right click, new user, and then you provide some username, login name here. So what I will do is I will create a user who can access multiple databases. So in that case, so that I can use it for other databases also. Okay, you go to this security here. So instead of install the database, so you can see there is a security here, right? So go here, login, right click, new login, and here select SQL Server authentication, and let me select SA test. Okay, give some password. For demo purpose I'm just giving any password, you whatever you are comfortable with, so just give that password, and better deselect this one, enforce password expiration, and default database I am selecting student. Okay, and in the server roles, I am making this person sysadmin, right? This user sysadmin. So yeah, so once I do that, click on OK, So the user has been created. Let's go to student database. Here the user should also appear. Let's go here and let's refresh. Let's refresh this. Okay, it is not appearing. Server role user mapping is student, right? So security status enable permission grant. Okay, we can give these things, but let's not give this. These are high level permissions, what we can do is I think this should be okay. So click on okay and again go here, refresh. Okay, so now asset test is coming up, right? So asset test is our new user. Let's see if so here let's make this person DB owner, okay? So that by default then it will get all the permissions, alter, grant, create, everything it will get, okay? Or you can make, like, if you don't want DB owner, you can just reader, writer, you can do that also, okay? So for a simplification purpose, DB owner, but from security point of view, it is not that good to make someone DB owner. Only for this tutorial purpose, I am doing it. And once you have done that, let's see here also DB owner. And so username, login name, everything created by default. So let's click on OK. So asset test has been created, okay? Now let's try to connect and see if we are able to connect using asset test. So asset test. Yes, so I'm able to connect now. So if you're unable to see this, let me disconnect everything and show you once again. I think it was too quick. So file, connect, explorer, asset test. Okay, it is selected asset test. So you have to select SQL Server authentication here and asset test, and then type your password, and now this is coming up, right? So now you are logged in as asset test. So you are able to see these tables here. These are some dummy tables I have created just for this tutorial purpose. You can create these tables. It is very simple. So you can create as many tables as you want. So like new query, create tables, okay? There, if you're new to this, you can go to W3Schools. I'll recommend that is very good for beginners. You can go to W3Schools. It has all these basic commands. You can follow that and you can create these tables or delete tables, alter tables. All these commands are there, okay? So now we have these three tables which has some data in it. So let's close this and then go to Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code, now this is the interface of Visual Studio Code. You can download it for free. It is also available for free for development purpose. The thing is that whatever you want to do, you have to install a extension for it, okay? So go to this extensions here and search for SQL Server. So click on this SQL Server. You can see SQL Server coming up, install. It will take a couple of minutes to install. Okay, now SQL Server is installed. So close this and then you can see these icons here. So go to SQL Server and here click on add connection. Okay, your add connection, you have to type the name. So this name should be this name here. Okay, so let me copy this and copy and go back to Visual Studio Code and then paste it here and press enter. Yeah, database name we already know. So student, press enter. You have SQL login here, so select that, and here it will ask for username. Our username is asset test. So again enter, and then the password, and again enter, right? It will ask you to save the password. I don't want to save the password. No profile name. I will give student DB, and then hit enter. So now it's testing. You can see here, and profile created and connected. So profile is this name that comes up here, okay? So that's my connect. You can have multiple connections, so you can identify those connections using your profile name. So now student DB has been created. Go to tables. You can see all these tables here, right? So now let's run a query. So select top 1000, If I do that, then it will take a while. It will be a little bit slower compared to SQL Server, because SQL Server directly, the database is there, so it will be very quick. Whereas Visual Studio goes to SQL Server and then retrieves the data, so it takes a while. But you can see this things has been retrieved. So for example, I can also go to, let's say, this table here. These are all dummy data I have just created. So you can create any type of table or insert any type of data, whatever you want or whatever is needed for your project. So now you can see, so I was able to retrieve data from both these tables. So let's run a create command. So close this windows. Let's use this window and let's create a table as well. Yeah, so create table. Table name is let's say student city. Yeah, then bracket and give id int identity, so which means automatically it will be incremented, no need for me to insert it, inserting data here, and then id and then city. Okay, varchar and 50. So that's it. Now let's execute this. So you can see this button here, execute query. So it will then come up with some message on this pane here that the table has been created. Okay, now you can see command completed successfully. So the table has been created. It is not appearing here because we have to refresh it. So refresh it, and then student city is coming up, right? Now you can again run an insert query and insert the data in this table. Okay, so now let's insert something. So the table doesn't have any data. So to insert something in this table, we have to type a insert command. So insert into table name is table name is this. Okay, dbo dot student city is not coming. City values bracket and then. Okay, so you can see that one row has been created. Let's insert some other records. Daily. New York. Okay, so three records should be in this table now. Right click, select top 1000, and so this should come up here now. Okay, so now you can see the city names are coming up here. So that's it. So we have run the select command, we have run the create table command, and let's run a delete command as well. Let's see if we can delete delete from. Right, so now I have deleted all the records. Okay, three rows affected. So if I close this, let's close this window, windows, and again run a select command on this. So now nothing should come up, only the column names should appear. There should not be any record in this table. Okay, so you can see here. So on the ID and city, nothing is coming up because we have deleted. So create table, delete table, select. I have shown you all these three examples. So now you can follow this and enjoy your Visual Studio Code and SQL Server. Okay. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this video. Please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you very much.